I'd like to thank the sponsors for this debate. I think Ronald Reagan said it best, you cannot be a true conservative without also being a libertarian. He went on to say that if fascism ever came to America, it would be in the form of liberal ideology. The liberal ideology is a disease that is infecting our country from within and has all but consumed the Democratic Party. Liberalism has turned the once blue-collar party that represented the middle class into a party that represents special interest groups and the mega-rich. They have lost touch with the middle-class American. Their politicians blindly follow the party line dogma, always putting party over country. We cannot continue to vote liberal ideology into government and keep the American dream alive. Just look how far our country has fallen in 6 years of liberal rule. If you want to see the effects of 40 years of democratic liberal policies, look at Detroit. The Democrats are not alone. Liberalism has also infiltrated the Republican Party, and we see proof of that in the voting records of several Republican politicians. None, however, better demonstrated in the fact than my opponent, Blake Farenthold. His voting record, according to GovTrack.us, is more liberal than most Democrats. The Republican Party is also guilty of blindly following party lines. They, too, are full of globalists and corporate trills, representing the mega-rich. They, too, are always putting party over country. It is time we start putting our country as our priority again. I will bring back the voice of the American people back to our government. I believe in personal freedoms and personal responsibility that comes with freedoms as guaranteed through our Constitution. These beliefs are the fabric of our nation. The old phrases, don't tread on me and live free or die, are not just empty, outdated words. They are the truth of our heritage, and that must be embraced once again. I believe in the American people's exceptionalism and the ability to rise and conquer challenges we face when the government steps out of the way. I believe that when we allow the American spirit of innovation and creativity to flourish unhindered by the government, we all win.
Mr. Reed.
I'm Wesley Reed, and I'm a husband, father, Marine, and proud Corpus Christian. I'm running for Congress because, like so many of my fellow Texans, I'm tired of our government being run for the benefit of a well-connected few at the expense of the hardworking people that make up the vast majority of this country. Wall Street profits are at an all-time high, but income for Texas families are stagnant. Our local bases are unprotected by the current congressman, and security of our nation is uncertain. This isn't right, but the Washington establishment and politicians like my opponent either don't see or don't care. They're too busy infighting and padding their profits of their Wall Street donors with our tax dollars. It almost makes me afraid to ask what else these politicians are too busy to deal with. The 114th Congress will face a world in crisis. Russia is falling back into old habits. ISIS is spreading crises across the Middle East. And the World Health Organization is struggling to get the Ebola pandemic under control. But with all this going on, Congress has worked only 105 days this year. I'm just a simple Marine, but when I do the math, that's 260 days of not securing the future of Social Security and Medicare, not fixing the problems of the VA, not guaranteeing equal pay for equal work, not tackling student loan debt, and not putting the American people first. It's time someone brought common sense back to Washington and remind those politicians that they work for the American people, not Wall Street. I'll fight to stop loaning our tax dollars to banks for almost nothing, while making Texas families pay more taxes and ever-increasing interest on student loans. I'll fight to ensure that our military remains the strongest in the world, and that we honor and keep the promises that we made to our veterans who have sacrificed so much already. And I'll stand up to the do-nothing politicians in Congress that refuse to work together to get our economy moving and working Americans back on the path to prosperity. This is still the greatest nation on earth, and our leaders' actions need to reflect that greatness. Working together, we can forge a new trail, one that reignites this nation's confidence and inspires the next generation of Americans to reach new heights of achievement beyond what we can even imagine today. I won't be able to do this overnight, but with your support, with your vote, we can and will start to forge this new path forward.
Thank you both. I have a question from the audience for Ms. Simonson. When was the last time a libertarian won a partisan race in Texas?
There has not been one.
Here's a question for Mr. Reed. Who would you vote for Speaker of the House?
Well, once we're elected, we'll have to see what politicians step forward to want to take on that role. And I'd look for the politician that's going to most accurately reflect the needs and concerns of South Texas. I think it's important that politicians put their communities first. So in my case, I'd be looking for someone who's going to stand up and fight for South Texas and the families that are down here, the veterans that are down here, and the small businesses that make up our great community.
All right, this question will be for both of you. And we'll start with Ms. Simonson. If elected, what will your top priorities in the next Congress be? What will you do to help the Coastal Bend?
I feel that the Coastal Bend, we need fresh water. I feel that adding a desalinization plant would help our economy, would help the economic growth in our area, and also create jobs.
Mr. Reed.
We have several problems here in the Coastal Bend. We have veterans that need help. We have an education system that's overburdened. We have small businesses that need great assistance. We have infrastructure that our ports and our military bases need great help with. And our farmers need water. As a child who grew up, had grandparents that were farmers, I understand the needs that farmers have in our community. I understand the needs of our veterans, the benefits that they were promised when they were willing to make the sacrifices for our country, that we keep those promises to them. Our bases and our ports continue to need infrastructure to continue to grow and expand and do the great job they do. Last but not least, regarding desalination, I think it's important for the federal government to partner with local government and local private businesses to work on desal projects to ensure that our industry and our citizens have the water they need to continue to move forward and work effectively.
Thank you. The next question is directed to Mr. Reed. How do you feel about the United States warming up to dictators, and would you show your support to the Democratic leaders?
Well, you'd have to point out which dictators we're talking about, but I think it's important that as America, we go around the world and we help out countries that are having problems in their own countries. We have a great deal of resources in our country itself. We have the ability and if we have the wherewithal to go in there and help them to fix crises they have, to make sure they have the tools they need to be successful, to make sure we have our police department, our partnering with their local law enforcement agencies to get their crime under control, our economists working with their economists to get their economies under control and working efficiently. I think we have a responsibility to do that.
Thank you. The next question is for Ms. Simonson. As the Libertarian candidate, you have only an outside chance of being elected. So why should we bother to vote for you?
As a Libertarian, we are for the people. We are the people. And I do believe that our country needs to realize that all these politicians, that is exactly what they are, career politicians. And we need to bring back this country to the people, for the people.
Thank you. The next question is for Mr. Reed. Given the corrupting influence of money in politics, will you vote for an amendment to the United States Constitution to state that corporations are not people and thus do not have constitutional rights, and that money is not speech and thus can be regulated by campaign finance laws?
I would vote for that amendment. I think that recent decisions by the Supreme Court the last couple of years that have allowed an unlimited flow of money into politics has really polluted the system. We have a great many citizens in our country and our communities that could do a great job representing the people here, but the cost of running for office has gotten out of control. Whether you're running for city council, district judge, county judge, state rep, it has cut out so many great people that have great ideas and are great leaders in their community from keeping them from making a difference. And I think if we remove some of the money from the system, that we show that corporations aren't people. They don't get hurt. They don't get married to the people they love. They don't get cancer. They're not people, so they shouldn't be afforded the same rights.
Thank you. Ms. Simonson, do you think that government is too big? If so, what would you do to shrink it and make it more efficient?
Yes, I do believe that our government is too big. I would introduce legislation requiring government programs program dictators, and department heads to be held accountable for the losses due to waste, fraud, and abuse. They should be held to the same standards as any CEO in charge of a company or corporation. I believe that when we pass bills, they need to be a clean bill. I believe that they need to be written in layman's terms that the everyday American can understand.
Thank you. This question is for both candidates. Who will assist in sponsoring an amendment to the Federal Fair Credit Act to require all creditors and reporting agencies to immediately remove any items related to an existing ongoing law enforcement investigation?
Remove the from the files, the fact that they're being investigated, is that the question? Is that the way I hear it?
I think so.
Well, one, until you're convicted of a crime, I don't think it should reflect in anybody's history, legal history, credit history, personal history. Up until that point, you've been charged. And I believe in being afforded due process is one of the great liberties that our citizens in our country are afforded. And I'm opposed to that, or opposed to having those credit records reflect crimes that you've been charged with.
I do agree with my opponent, Wesley Reed.
Thank you. Here's another one for both of you. Veterans' benefits are being taken away. And then the next says their families. So how will you bring that back? It relates to veterans' benefits being taken away.
It seems to me that whenever we have a crisis with our government, the first people they want to hurt are our veterans and our senior citizens. I think it's time that we as people need to stand up for our veterans and their families, because they did do a great service to our country, and it's time that we show them the respect that they deserve.
The audience is not participating in the forum, but here's a clarification that was further down on the card. It says, after the veterans have passed away, do you believe benefits should be taken away from the veterans' family?
No, I do not, because the military families and the veterans' families, they also go through the same trials and tribulations as the veterans do themselves. And being a former military brat, I do understand this.
Mr. Reed.
Well, having served 25 years in my beloved Marine Corps, my dad 25 plus years in the Air National Guard, my kid brother several tours in Iraq in the Army, I understand what the veterans are counting on when they look to what the promises that have been made to them when they sign on the dotted line. That when you're willing to go out there and sacrifice your life for your country, your family's willing to sacrifice their time for you being gone all those years, that the promises that we made to you when you joined the military, when you sign on the dotted line, we will keep that to you. We don't go back and try to threaten to cut your disability payments or put them at jeopardy because we're going to shut the government down and tell them you have to make a sacrifice for National Party goals. We don't cut veterans' benefits to balance the budget. We do not balance the budget on the backs of our veterans. To do so is, in my opinion, worthy of a dishonorable discharge.
Thank you. This will have to be our last question for the U.S. representative candidates. And we'll start with Mr. Reed this time. How would you balance the economy and the environment from Washington, D.C.?
Well, I think we can do both if we're willing to make smart decisions and be efficient with our government. I believe that some of the greatest growth opportunities we have in the country are our small businesses with the green companies, green energy companies. We need to continue to invest in our small independent oil and gas companies in the Coastal Bend in Texas and move some of that investment away from multinational corporations. These small independent oil and gas companies that live here and work here on a daily basis are the fastest growing businesses in our economy. But if we partner with them, we partner with green community, with green energy companies, wind, solar, geothermal, I think we continue to address this issue of ours, which is energy security in our country, and continue to make our country stronger moving forward, reducing our reliance upon oil from the Middle East and from Venezuela.
Ms. Simonson.
I believe we need to shrink our government by 40% by eliminating or combining overlapping agencies such as the USDA, the FDA. I also believe that we need to have less government and less government spending and lower taxes, which will stimulate our economy and increase our GDP, which creates jobs and raises our tax revenue.
Thank you. Now, each candidate will have an opportunity for a one-minute closing statement, and we will begin with Mr. Reed.
I think what we have at stake here in front of us in this community is the future of our children. We have a great opportunity here in our community that if we're willing to invest in our children, invest in our community, we can achieve great things. I think it's important that we have somebody in Congress that represents all of us here in this district, someone that has lived the same life that our community has. Someone that has lived a life on the farm, that has worked the middle class jobs, whether it's stocking shelves, throwing papers, doing landscaping, picking tobacco, working in factories, enlisting the Navy or and joining the Marine Corps as an officer. I think that's the type of person that our community deserves representing them. Someone that's willing to stand up and fight for them on a daily basis. Someone that wears his heart on his sleeve and that will understand the pains and tribulations and joy that our community experiences on a daily basis because he has lived it just like they have.
Ms. Simonson.
I am not here today. I am not here as a libertarian. I am not here as a politician, but I am here as an American citizen just like you for our children's future. I am here today because I can no longer sit back and watch the Democrats and the Republicans put their party's best interest over our country's best interest. My promise to you is this: I will always put our country first. I will never put party over country. I will always answer to the American people. I will bring the voice of the people back to the people, back to our government. I believe that our best days as a nation can still be in our future, just as generations past have hoped and believed and look forward to eager anticipation. I believe in a strong military that can only be used with trepidation, not profit, a military that commands respect and garners international fear so never to be challenged, a defense that walks softly but carries a huge stick. I believe in securing our borders once and for all and implementing a fair and sensible immigration policy with our neighbors, following the rule of law and enforcing it stringently. We should restrict or eliminate immigration from countries that wish us harm. I believe in energy independence and increased trade with our friends in Canada and Latin America. The Keystone Pipeline should be built immediately. Oil and natural gas exploration should be increased and its resources being utilized domestically to its full potential. In short, I believe in America.
Your time is up, Ms. Simonson.
Okay.
Thank you both very much for participating in tonight's forum.